Hi, I'm Kelsey Bisson, and I'm the program scientist for NASA's Ocean Biology and Biogeochemistry program. I'm introducing the challenge, What's Up With This Water? Have you ever been swimming in a natural body of water and felt curious about the microscopic and larger life around you, or what else has been living in the water? We know that there's a vast amount of life in oceans, rivers, and lakes, most of which cannot be seen with our own eyes. Your challenge is to create an app that notifies people of endangered species in the bodies of water around them, with information about what people can do to help preserve these species and use the water for recreation in the most respectful way. We all check weather apps, sometimes every day, to learn how we can go dress in the world and prepare ourselves for what's to come. Much less attention is paid to our water systems. There are a number of reasons to learn more about your local water ecosystem, particularly practical logistical concerns with water quality, ethical concerns with endangered species, and also with water quality when it comes to drinking water and who it has access to clean drinking water, and scientific curiosities, including where the water mass was prior to swimming in it, for example, if you're in the ocean, as well as what's living in the water in terms of interesting creatures that are inspirational in their own ways. People need to know if water is safe before they go swimming. And ideally, they can also learn about the endangered species in the water and how that we can best support our ecosystem. There's additional knowledge and other curiosities. For example, learning where the water has been through ocean circulation in the days, weeks, and months before swimming in it. And we envision a future ultimately where people can check a water weather app to learn the conditions of their local bodies of water, as well as how they can support continued water health while they're there. So your challenge is to create an app for users that allows them to check the water quality of their waterway. And in addition, features of the app would be, for example, check what local endangered species are living in the water, as well as how to protect them, as well as perhaps where the water has been in a circulatory sense. If, for example, you can imagine you're swimming in North Carolina, that water mass that you're swimming in was likely previously in the south in the Gulf of Mexico, and then came up through the Gulf Stream. The app is meant to be very similar to a weather app, but much more simplistic. We really, really stress that participants who are interested in this challenge think about what they would find most interesting when using a water weather app and what sort of additional features they would find most useful, playful, and inspiring.